Russia will send more COVID-19 vaccines to the Philippines. Malacanang says Russian President Vladimir Putin made that promise during a phone call with Philippine leader Rodrigo Duterte on June 2nd, as the two countries mark 45 years of bilateral relations. Sputnik V, the vaccine developed by Gamaleya Institute, is the second government-procured jab that has been delivered to the Philippines after Sinovac's CoronaVac. Manila has procured at least 80,000 doses of the Russian vaccine.
The U.S. says its plans to distribute vaccines globally will be done according to need and not in exchange of any political favor. That reiteration coming from U.S. Deputy Secretary of State Wendy Sherman, who is currently in Bangkok for the second leg of her diplomatic tour. American President Joe Biden has committed to give away 80 million doses to the global vaccine sharing facility, COVAX. The Philippines is set to receive some, but the number of doses has yet to be confirmed.
The Philippine Health Department urges the public to complete their vaccination against COVID-19. That's after an expert working with the government said more than a million people who got their first jabs from March to May failed to come back for a second dose. The DOH believes they may have gotten sick or developed coronavirus symptoms, preventing them from going to their next vaccine appointment.
Mga nagkaroon ng sakit, na-expose, nag-quarantine, at hindi po nakuha ang kanilang mga second doses, immediately after that you get sick and you are declared recovered, ibig sabihin, pagkatapos ng 10 araw na isolation, wala nang simptomas, o di kaya, wala kayo talagang simptomas pero positibo kayo, after 14 days of isolation, pwede na po tayong magpabakuna immediately after. Hindi po kailangang ulitin na first dose po ang ibibigay sa inyo. Pumalik lamang po kayo sa vaccination site and you will be given your second dose.
Dr. John Wong, member of the COVID-19 Task Force's Sub-Technical Working Group on Data Analytics, adds government was not able to hit its target of vaccinating 1/5 of senior citizens and people with comorbidities. Only 14% of senior citizens, or the A2 group, have been vaccinated so far, while only 8% of people with comorbidities, or the A3 category, have received the jab.
Despite missing its vaccination targets for the A2 and A3 categories, COVID-19 vaccine chief Carlito Galvez Jr. says the government will start the inoculation of the fourth priority group, or economic frontliners. Galvez notes those in the indigent sector and other essential workers living in the NCR plus 8 bubble will go first in a mini rollout to be conducted on June 7th. This comes as the Philippines expects the arrival of nearly 10 million additional COVID vaccines from Sinovac, Pfizer, and AstraZeneca this month.
Noong nagkaroon kami ng IATF meeting, napakasunduan na hatiin lang sa dalawa. Okay. On age level. So ang gagawin natin is 40 and up ang first priority and then ang next is 39 and below. Ayun. Kasi nakita po natin sa science, medyo vulnerable po yung mga 40 and up. Yung LGU may opt to use that tinatawag nating prioritization.
The Philippines logged 5,257 new COVID-19 cases Wednesday, bringing the total number of active cases to over 52,000. 146 additional deaths were recorded, while 6,000 more patients recovered. Data from the Okta Research Group show from May 26 to June 1, average cases of COVID-19 in the country increased by 37% compared to the week before. The group explains this reversal of trend is because the National Capital Region did not see a decrease in cases, which would have countered the upward trend in other areas. Given the situation, an infectious disease expert has expressed concern over government's move to allow point-to-point leisure travel from the so-called NCR Plus to areas under the least restrictive modified general community quarantine.
If you move more people from a GCQ area to a lower number of area with cases, pwede mangyari na those people who are there, nanggaling dito, can be transmitting the infection to this area. So sa akin naman, since this is a policy that to slowly open up the economy and normalize our natin dito, yung mobility natin, normal life, sa akin, we have to make it like gradual siguro, no? Like, why not ikabit doon yung may bakuna di ba? So, ang suggestion ko dyan is, dapat, bago ka pupunta, hindi lang negative RT-PCR, at least nabakunahan ka na.